In this chapter, the following topics are going to be discussed. Number one, what is maintenance? Number two, maintenance classification. Number three, necessity of maintenance. Number four, failure of structure. And number five is reason for failure of structure. So like we are going to walking for reduce our weight and the belly. So that is another example to maintain our human body. Like as well as yoga, that is also an exercise to reduce our stress, BP, and avoid the brain strokes, etc. So these are all like some of the examples for the maintenance of our body. So likewise, we are going to take care of our building structures also. And another example now trending is coronavirus. You can see that we want to regularly wash our hands, wearing mask, the surroundings to be making clean. So like this, we are taking care of ourselves to maintain our body in a perfect manner. So like this, we should take care of our buildings also to maintain the structure throughout the lifetime. Coming back to the civil engineering maintenance. So what is maintenance? So maintenance is preventive in nature. So we say that worm and cobworm and all the proverbs. Like this, maintenance is preventive in nature. So example, we should take care of our body to prevent from the fever due to some the climatic changes, etc., etc. In summer, normally we used to drink more water or tender coconut to reduce the maintain our body condition in a good manner. Likewise, we should maintain our structures also. Second point is activities which include inspection and works necessary to fulfill the intended function or to sustain original standard of the service. So perfect inspection to be carried out all time through for the building. The maintenance of the structure is done to meet the following objective. So what is the objective? So some objective should be there for maintenance. What is the objective? Prevention of damages due to natural agency. We are going to see what are the different natural agencies at all in the upcoming slides. And to keep them in a good appearance and working condition. Repair of the defects occurred in the structure and strengthen them if necessary. So example, whenever we have some rainy season or etc., we used to take care of our structure, and for some other reasons also some we will take care. So like that, so some defects and to be taken care before the structure should be get maintained in the proper way. That is the main objective. Maintenance classification. The maintenance work is broadly classified as four types. Number one, preventive maintenance. Number two, remedial maintenance. Number three, routine maintenance. Number four, special maintenance. Preventive maintenance, worm and cobworm. So remedial maintenance, what we want to do after we get affected. So fever. So like that, we are going to take care. So immediately it should be taken care. Otherwise, it may affect some other parts. And we may have a running nose, cough, etc., and it may go on to stomach pain, etc., etc. So we should immediately take care of our human body whenever we start with some problem. So like that, our structure also we should take care immediately when the surface gets some defects or damage. So what are the basic steps? Finding the deterioration, finding the mistakes or errors or failures or causes, etc. And it may, so that only we can identify that it may develop cracks or it may collapse, etc. So we want to identify the reasons also, and evaluating the strength of the existing structure, whether that structure will be far enough to withstand for the future, so that only we can able to maintain it or we want to replace it. Like that only we want to estimate the life of the structure. Structure means it includes everything, starts from basic flooring, pipes, electrical switches, etc., all the things. Selecting and implementing the repair procedure. We should take the repair procedure in the perfect manner. Example, again, I am going back to the doctor topic itself. We are identifying one doctor and we are going to have an appointment and we are telling that I am suffering from fever and so on so issues. He should give perfect medicine to cure our fever. So likewise, we should implement the correct procedure to take care of our structure. If the doctor gives any wrong medicals or any wrong treatment, then our structure, our human body will get some more damage or more fever, etc. It may lead to death also. We are seeing in newspapers, etc. So like this, if you are doing some repair work wrongly, that also defects the structure or it may lead to collapse in the future. And next is routine maintenance. So it is a service maintenance attended to the structure periodically. So example, you can see in our houses, water doctor, they used to come every 3 months and they will remove all the dust particles settled in that and they will place some new knobs, etc. Like that, and the UPS battery we used to fill with distilled water, etc. So this is a service maintenance attend to the structure periodically like this. The nature of work done and interval of time and which it is done depends upon the specifications again and materials of structures purpose. That is the main thing. Should be done for not needed for all the structures. Particularly whatever it is needed only we should take in care of the routine works. Intensity and condition of use. For example, we are water doctor, as I said earlier, that is we are using daily. So it should be conditionally. It is to be conditioned in all time. So routine maintenance should be taken care. So like this, we are using the doors and windows routinely. So we want to take care of the doors and windows and some other structures, civilizing structures, normal floorings. We used to put some patchworks whenever it happens. Like that, routine maintenance should be taken care. So they mention about it includes whitewash, patch repair to plasters, replacing of fittings and fixtures, binding of road surface, etc. Normally, you know, Tamil Nadu, we people normally used to have whitewash once in a year. That is, during the Pongal time, we used to have whitewash in the olden days. Whereas now, it has become painting. So normally in olden days, we have only white paint on all the structures, all the houses. Whereas now we have changed it from white itself, we are having 100 whites. So whitewashing normally used to do in the Pongal time. Whereas now nowadays, if we need the whitewash, we are doing it once in a year. Or even sometimes I wash in my friend's houses or my relative's houses. Two times itself within a year, they used to have the painting surrounding the buildings. So patch repair to plasters. So we may have some spalling of structures somewhere else. And the floorings also due to the vehicle movements and keeping any cylinders, etc. So that flooring may get dangerous. So we want to repair that plaster works. Replacement of fittings, toilet fittings, etc. You can see that the health facet will get repaired normally within a time duration of 6 months to 8 months. So that should be taken care of properly. Like that, etc. We want to take care of more objects. And normally for Ayuda Puja also we used to clean all the objects in the building. So at that time we are going to clean all the doors and windows. So that itself far enough for the doors and all the joineries for maintained for a long time. And the fixtures also, electrical switches like this, etc. And next is special maintenance. So it is the work done under special condition and requires sanction and perform to rectify heavy damages, okay, like spalling of concrete from roof slab. So that this may be heavy damages because it may lead to death. So that is to be heavy damages. So special condition to be taken care for the maintenance work. Next point, it may be done for strengthening. As I said, spalling of concrete. So strengthening is needed and updating of the structure to meet the new condition of usage or to increase its serviceability. So for this updating of the structure to meet the new condition, I will have an example. So if a building is having ground and first floor, the first floor might be used as residential for a long time. And after a time period of 10 or 15 years, the owner might be planned to have some godown in the first floor. Example, dress or any other materials to be kept over here. We will design the structure only for residential building. So the life load may be as per IS 456. I don't know. I just forgot it the value. It may be around 3. So whereas while we're keeping it as a godown, it may be changed. The increase in live load will happen. So updating of structure to meet that condition means we should increase its serviceability. That's what I like to mention here. So converting a residential building floor slab to a godown means we should update the structure. That's what we need in the special maintenance. It may include particular or complete renewal occurring at long intervals. So such as floors, roofs, etc. So our floors and roofs should be taken care particularly. So for us, whereas in India or particularly in Tamil Nadu, we used to have mop our floors in our homes, you know, all Fridays normally or some occasions. So our floors are always getting maintained in a well manner The roofs also, for each and every summer, we are going to have some roof painting, that means at the rooftop, for increase the weathering materials. So that may be under special maintenance. Next is necessity of maintenance. So what is the necessity? So the causes which necessitate the maintenance effects are the service and durability of the structure as follows. Number one, atmospheric gases. Number two, normal wear and tear. And number three, failure of a structure. Physical, chemical effects. The water available in the nature contains some acids. So everyone knows that. And alkaline and other compounds in dissolved form acts over the material to give rise, which is known as chemical weathering. And wind property, it is the agent which transports the abrasive material, assists the physical weathering. Its action is aggravator during rains, and when it is moving with high speed, it may contain acidic gases like CO2 fumes, which may act over the material and penetrates quite deeply into materials and structure. So again, we have studied in engineering geology that during wind, so some particles may move from one place to another place, and in that place it will start to groan, or that that object may disturb the existing structure by mode of any other gases or some acid contains in that. So example, one rock move from rock means it's very tiny particles, I'm saying about stone, it may start moving from one place to other place, and it may attach over the existing rock in the second place. So it may develop some problem reaction with the rocks, and it may cause us to failure. So that's what the concept which you have studied in the engineering geology. And the important thing is temperature effect. The seasonal and annual variation of the temperature, difference in temperature in two parts of the materials and the surface of material causes expansion and contraction. Whenever we feel the temperature, I said that summer and winter, how you feel in opening and closing of doors during these two seasons, that is the again fact here. This movement of material bond and adhesion between them is lost when it is repeated. So this process is go on repeating, expansion, contraction, expansion and contraction. So the bonding will be getting reduced. That's what it is been mentioned. So example, Chennai Airport. Why I have mentioned Chennai Airport is, we can see in the newspapers or TV news, etc. The fall ceiling has fall down for the continuously. So 50th time, successfully 50th time. Now 60th, 70th, 75th, memory is correct now, the number is exactly between 70 to 80. So what is the reason? Due to temperature only. So the glasses has been fitted with some bolts and nuts. Okay, four glasses have been fitted at one with one support, or one corner has been used for other conditions, vice versa, like that. The variation in temperature. So inside the Chennai International or domestic airport, we are having air conditioned temperature. So the temperature will get between normally 20 to 30. Whereas in the outside, it is heavy. We know that whenever in summer, Chennai will be Chennai and Velu districts will be more in temperature. So during this, so the temperature inside will be slightly 20 to 30, whereas outside it is 35 plus. So what happened? Immediately the temperature on the both sides is getting changed. So it will, the material bond will get reduced, and the life of that bonding is also get reduced. So due to continuous process in expansion and contraction, the glass has lost its properties and it get fault. That is the reason, main reason in Chennai Airport. This responsible for the development of cracks, and the rocks may break away into small units. Again, from the engineering geology, long time, after a long tenure, the rocks will get break and it will make into tiny particles. Exploitation or peeling of the shell takes place if exterior layer are heated externally with respect to internal layers. That's what in Chennai Airport happened. The temperature variation may also cause change in the structure and chemical composition of the material. Yeah, that's what we have feel in the bricks. Outside the cracks may be high, in the inside the cracks may be less in our structures. Next is normal wear and tear. During the use of structure, it is subjected to abrasion, and thereby it loses appearance and serviceability. It's and I just mentioned D has been missing here. So example, you may study in concrete technology or some other subject, about our wear and tear test for aggregates and flooring. Flooring means outside we used to have some paver block flooring or some other material wear and tear test. Example, you may see in TV that one dosa cooking, they used to give advertisement that one you can prepare 1 lakh dosas or some 5 lakh dosas, so that the base material will not get damaged. So it, up to 5 lakh dosa it is guaranteed that you can use like this. So like this we want to take care of the flooring and the aggregates for normal wear and tear during the life. Next is failure of structure. Failure is defined as the behavior of structure not in agreement with expected condition of stability or lacking freedom from necessary repair or non-compliance with desired use of and occupancy of the completed structure. So normally we used to design a structure for 99 years. So whenever you may see in any quotes, the life of the building depends on the usage. It may be mentioned that 0, 25, 50 and 99. So our structure is 99 years and there is agreement with expected condition of stability. We are having an agreement or a expected condition of stability of a structure always good or lacking freedom from necessary repair so that it may be considered. In field, it may result in visual collapse of the structure or even suspension of the services. So in field, it may not occur. In field, it may be different from considering the theory or some other part. Visual collapse itself, we can able to see. Example, that is the collapse of towers. That self microwave towers we used to have that and for cell phone as well as transmission line towers it used to get fall. So you can see, you know, within the last week or even the last 2 days, Kerala, Ooty, we are just seeing number of failures of structures due to heavy rain. So that may be lead to collapse. We are carrying the designs properly only, but apart from our conditions, the structure material or workmanship, it may get fall. Sliding and overturning of dam, so unsettlement of foundation. Normally in our structure itself we are feeling settlement of foundation due to improper planning or improper construction of the bottom. Crushing of columns, so settlement of foundation leads to buckling or crushing of columns, etc. What are the reasons for failures of structure? Number one, improper design. As I said earlier, due to incorrect, insufficient data regarding use, loading and environmental conditions, selection of material, poor detailing. So the important thing we want to consider is only loading and environmental condition. Depends on that and environmental and loading conditions only you want to design this building as per the conditions in the codal books available. So if you are not visiting the site itself, sitting in the office, you are just receiving a plan that design this structure in Chennai. In Chennai where, whether it's a coastal condition or the other part or the middle part, so you want to know that. Since you are just know that where the location, just knowing that Chennai, okay, I'm designing like that, that may be lead to in conditions. And as well as loading, you may consider for a residential building later on stages, if it is converted to good one, as we said earlier, as we discussed earlier, then it may lead to collapse. Selection of material, that is the important thing. So like nowadays we are seeing many fake materials in the field, so try to take care some basic test of the material so that only we can able to use for our structure. Poor detailing, that means drawing whatever we are receiving or whatever we are giving to our client or engineers, that should be in detail. If it is poor, just giving that 8 numbers of 16 number, where to provide that 8 numbers, you should give the detail, everything to be in pakka. Next is defective construction. Poor materials, again with continuation to the previous one, poor workmanship. So as we, there is one comedy in a movie that Sendhil used to tell Gowdamani that ure kettu pochana kaila spanner vachana mechanic and like that. Nowadays we are seeing that n number of persons in the field that having trouble in his hand and saying that I am masdoor class A. So like that, poor workmanship, lack of quality control and supervision. Again, lack of quality control, the code has given many codal conditions to see taken care of the quality control. So in IS 456 you have some criteria, you have studied in concrete technology, so acceptance and rejection criteria, so that should be taken care. And improper supervision, first you know that what is happening there, then only you can able to explain that. So you want to study that first properly. improper use of structure. Again, as I said, using planning for a residential building and converting that into a rental building, sorry, for a godown, that is overloading. Selecting the structure for use which they are not designed. That's what I'm mentioning, that lack of maintenance, lack of upkeep, proper protection, precaution and the preservation deteriorate the structure, which may result in the failure. Proper protection. So like painting, if it is coating to be given, what is depends on the locality of the structure. If it is nearby seashore, you want to give different paints. If you are living near the main roads, there is heavy traffic roads, you want to give more protection, coating to be added, or the proper materials and to be used. So this may also lead to the